Hello and welcome. I'm glad you're here, and I hope this video teaches you something new and useful that you can use to make technology more effective for learning and teaching. Microsoft Windows is an operating system that's used all over the place. Work, home, school. And the Microsoft Windows operating system has a whole bunch of built-in functionality. It's a very powerful operating system that does a lot of things. But did you know that there are a whole bunch of features and utilities that are not installed in Microsoft Windows, but were written by Microsoft and are available for free? Meaning that we don't have to go out and buy certain utilities, we don't have to go and download free software or pay in the future software from websites that we don't really know the developers of. We can use Microsoft written utilities and features and install them into our Microsoft Windows operating system. And in this video, I'm going to show you two ways that we can do this. One is by going to the Microsoft Store and getting a set of extensions for Windows called PowerToys. And then I'm going to show you a website, a Microsoft website, learn.microsoft.com, where we can go and get a suite of tools called sysinternals. It used to be called system internals, and it's been around for many years. And even though a lot of that sysinternals is aimed at administrators or people that need to configure things within the Windows environment, there are a lot of really good utilities that we can use as day-to-day users or power users. So let's go take a look at PowerToys and sysinternals and how they can benefit us for free. The free add-ons and the free utilities are available in two different places from Microsoft. The first is PowerToys, which is available through the Microsoft Store. The second is sysinternals, which is available through a website. I'll link the website down below. It's learn.microsoft.com sysinternals, and PowerToys is available on the Microsoft Store. When you search for PowerToys on the Microsoft Store, you're going to see that you'll install it. I've already installed it for this video. And then what I'll get is the ability to open up PowerToys, and all of these utilities are now installed on my system. Underneath the General tab, you'll want to make sure that you're running as an administrator with these toys. If you're not, it'll say Restart PowerToys as Administrator, and I've set mine to have them always run as administrator. Underneath here, I can go and configure each of the individual different toys that I have. There's a lot in here that I really like. There are some File Explorer add-ons that are really useful. There are things like the image resizer, which is very, very useful. I use that all the time. There's a text extractor, so I can go in and actually, you can see here, Windows Shift T enables the text extractor. So let's say I'm on a web page and there's some sort of sign, an image of a sign, and I want to extract the text from that. I can do that. So there's a lot of different things we can do. I'm not going to go in this video and talk about absolutely all of them. The key here is that underneath PowerToys, I'm actually on the PowerToy settings here. Once I've installed PowerToys though, it affects the different areas of my operating system. So if I go, for example, to my File Explorer, you can see here that I've got a file preview pane. That's because underneath View, I now have a preview pane option. And now if I do something like go into this boot image, you'll notice that when I select it, it actually gives me a preview of the file over here. I'm also able to go in and do things like right click, and I can do things like resize it. So that's actually a PowerToy that I've installed. That's the image resizer, which was part of the PowerToy suite that I put in here. I can do things like limit what I'm doing. I can go in and choose the size that I want to make this image, and then I can, you know, resize the image, and it'll go through and it'll create a resized image in a smaller format. That's really handy if I'm doing something along the lines of, let's say I have a high resolution image and I want to create a profile picture from it. It's very quick to create a smaller image of a larger image by using that tool. And it'll not delete the old file. It'll create a separate file. Well, in fact, if I go here, you can see underneath the image resizer, I can go in and I can put in the behaviors of how big that image will be. I can go in and have what type of encoder I want in here. So if I have specific types of encoders, a good one, for example, might be PNG. Now I'm starting to go through the utilities. You can see here that I can go in and make different changes here, how the file will be named, all of those types of things. So we can put the settings here with PowerToy settings, and then we can just use the PowerToys in the appropriate place. There's some really cool ones in here. Color Picker is another one that I use all the time. So you can do Control Shift C and it'll actually give you the hex value of a color that's on your screen. That's another useful one. I could make a video on probably all of these different tools alone. And let's take a look at the sysinternals tools. Now, sysinternals has been around for a long time. System Internals was a separate company that Microsoft acquired, and they always had a suite of tools that as a system administrator, I would purchase and use all the time. And you can see there's a whole bunch of different downloads here. So you can actually download all of these different tools. You can just grab the entire suite of System Internal tools and it'll do a large download of all these different utilities. It's all zipped up. Or if you need specific tools, for example, file and disk tools, you can see we have all these different tools in here that are just file and disk utilities. Things like moving files, things like looking at the NTFS info on a file. You can come back up here, networking utilities. There's some really cool ones here. For example, TCP view is a utility that I can use to look at my TCP endpoints. That's very exciting to people that are into networking. Active Directory utilities in there as well. There's also a lot of fun, different miscellaneous utilities in here. A couple of the ones that I like would be things like the blue screen screensaver, say that 10 times fast. That's a screensaver that makes it look like your system has crashed. I really like that one for my students when I'm teaching them how to work on computers, do computer maintenance. It's always nice when, you know, I do a test and I say, okay, everybody out of the room, and they all come in and all the screens are blue screened. And then eventually somebody wiggles their mouse and goes, wait a sec, it's just a screensaver. Ha ha ha. Anyways, you can do things like CPU stress testing in here. One of the utilities, Zoomit. I made a video on this on the channel just on Zoomit. So you can download it again as a utility by itself, or you can download it as part of the entire suite. But the Zoomit utility, once you install it, is a fantastic way of, you know, zooming in and out on stuff that's happening on your screen. And so, like I say, I've made an entire video just on that. So you can see there's so many utilities. You can spend a lot of time both playing with the PowerToys and playing with the sysinternals. The cool thing here is that they're all free and they're developed by Microsoft. I hope that you'll consider using PowerToys and sysinternals. And if you do, comment down below and let me know which utilities you're finding the most useful. Also, if this video was useful for you, hit the like button. And if you want to see me make more videos on some of these utilities in depth, you can check out my video on Zoomit. I did an entire video just showing how to use that particular utility from the sysinternals suite. And if there's anything you'd like to see me do in the future, feel free to comment down below. I'm happy to make videos on any of the utilities in sysinternals or some of the features of PowerToys. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.